biker bang, wheelchair, gasoline, mashed potatoes.
It's week nine!
Episode 5!
Wow!
We did it!
Wowie, wowie!
We said last week 4 might be it.
Mm-hmm.
Just
nope.
JK. Joe Paisley.
Dan Cummins.
And if you guys are wondering why we refer to it as Episode 5,
because
we don't even know what we're going to say, which is a scary way to live our life, but you notice how they're, you know, the fun way that they're named?
Yeah.
we just don't fucking know what we're going to say.
Know.
We don't know. So, you know,
it's named after the fact.
Scary. Family is always on edge around us. But that's the way it is.
On this Is We Dumb, I'm going to, for video watches, I'm going to be stiff neck guy.
I
just came from the doctor. So just got a couple stitches in my neck. All good. All fine.
Came from the doctor.
Stiff neck guy.
He karate chopped your neck.
He karate chopped my neck.
It's a weird procedure.
Mm-hmm.
So new episodes of Is We Dumb every Wednesday at noon Pacific time. And the goal, as always, is to come out on the other side of this episode being a little less dumb than we were heading in.
Exactly.
We look at other examples of people being stupid, go, I don't want to do that. That's not for me.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the flip side, of course, of the sliver of hope, which is the good examples of humanity.
You look at that, strive for.
I can be better. That's the goal. That's what we're doing here.
And I like the confessional part. I like having to think about the dumb things I've been doing and then shame myself each week.
Me too.
It does. It is
It's
humbling.
A new fetish of mine. It is good.
It's kind of cathartic too.
Yeah. Online, you can find us on Facebook and Instagram at Is We Dumb. Continue to send in that segment content. We are loving it. It is so much fun to go through that, you guys. You send that to dumb@isbedumb.com. And we're talking about the would you rather ideas, dumb idiots, one-star reviews. I mean, whatever it may be, send it in.
Yeah.
And then everything else, info@isbedumb.com. Find merch, badmagicmerch.com, isbedumb.com. And we do want to give one more big thank you to Pandora.
Yay.
Welcome to everybody skipping over from there to check us out, which is great.
Yes.
We love that. And a shout out to Spotify and our listeners over there because we once again...
Top 20 in the trending charts.
Hit that trending chart. And that's thanks to you guys, you know, clicking the little boop, the play button. And that puts us on the trending card. So that's great. That's a lot of fun.
Did you say trending card?
I didn't mean to, but I did.
That was such a fun image. Get in here, buddy. You're on the trending cart.
Yay!
And I picture like an old mine cart and then a little podcast, little like logo with like that's his head. And he has the little like white arms and legs cartoon body. He's like, hey,
let's have fun.
I'm going for a ride on a trending cart.
I pictured like Toy Story 3 or Toy or 2 or 3. I think it's 3. When like the big baby, but then everybody else is in the shopping cart.
Yes.
And he's pushing you around. Get in.
Get in here,
fun,
buddy.
Yay! Everyone's just cheering, having a good time. Well, let's get into it.
Let's do it.
Let's open things up with the very super most important starting question.
The very super most important starting question.
And this one was sent our way by fellow dummy John Thompson.
John.
And this is a fun one.
Okay.
Are you ready for this?
I like fun.
All right. Bring it up. Would you rather have permanent Cheeto dust on your fingers or have taste buds in your asshole?
What? To me, my gut is harder on this one in one direction than it's been on the other ones.
All right. Well, we got to talk it out.
Fuck.
Because you know there's going to be pitfalls.
God. Because immediately my brain goes to Cheeto. Yeah, I'll take the Cheeto dust. But I also hate Cheeto dust on my fingers so much that when eating Cheetos, which I fucking love, by the way.
Mm-hmm. Doritos? I mean, same boat.
Doritos. Cheetos, though.
They're more.
There's more.
The crispy,
more
dust, the fluffiness.
Mm-hmm.
And things get all over the place.
And it thickens on your fingers faster.
It's a paint.
Mm-hmm. Actually, this is so random. My daughter, Monroe, so far, you know, like as you get older, you develop, you know, weird quirks and stuff like that. Her first, like, really big quirk despises Cheeto dust.
Just can't stand it.
Like, can't stand it, won't eat Cheetos because of it. And also, if you eat Cheetos around her, she does not want to be touched by your gross Cheeto fingers. Like, it's the only thing where she's just, like gotten, like, really weirdly angry about that I've noticed so far.
Her and 12 Pepper, years old. My daughter, Pepper.
Hates Cheeto dust?
No, they cannot hang out.
Oh, because Pepper loves
Cheetos.
She's
a mess. It's embarrassing to bring her in public when there's Cheetos involved.
Because she just wants
to like,
what
do you
care.
Like, how did you do this? Like, you look at her, like, she's like a clown. Someone painted clown lips on her with Cheetos. I'm like, you're way too big to look like this.
You're
obnoxiously disgusting. Get out of my fucking face.
When I eat Cheetos, I have to, after about 2-3 minutes, maybe four minutes of some Cheetos, I got to scrape. I have a scrape technique on using my bottom teeth to get the Cheeto kind of crust off.
Right.
So that would be annoying to have that all the time because, that is annoying.
I mean, you think about the gloves. So you can put on some gloves.
You have to always wear gloves.
Always,
which I hate.
I mean, I feel like I could survive a year, maybe 2 years, half a decade or a decade into wearing gloves all the time. I would lose, I would cut my hands off.
And not even cool.
I talk myself, I don't need these that much, and chop my fucking hands off with a table saw. Like, that's how crazy I would go.
Mm-hmm. Just to get like prosthetic hands that don't have Cheeto dust fingers.
Yeah, I'd probably feel better at that point.
And you have to wear like full on gloves. You don't even get to wear like cool, like 80s switchblade fight fingerless gloves.
Yeah, like driving
motorcycle
a car.
Bang. Yeah. Bang, gang. Motorcycle Bang.
That sounds like an adult film.
It does. Motorcycle Bang 6.
Vroom, vroom.
Sprockets and holes. What?
Like, look at this ratchet.
Yeah, though, and I was just thinking about like how much time I spend just for research and everything, like on a keyboard. And your keyboard is a fucking nightmare all the time because of the Cheeto dust. And I think about touchscreen.
Can't touch it.
Can't touch it. And like the whole thing of like, that's how you get logged into a lot of things now, is like with a fingerprint and stuff like that. It ruins all of that. It
sure does. Think about intimacy time.
Intimacy.
Good luck.
What kind of Cheeto infections can women get with Cheeto dust in their vaginas?
You're going to find out for sure. I mean, before the infection spreads and kills your wife, it's going to be tasty, though.
No more happy fingers.
I mean,
nobody gets that.
No, but it's going to be a great taste in oral sex for you.
Ooh, that part's good.
But if it gets all thicky and okay,
maybe
mind.
It won't be.
No,
maybe
it won't be. This is terrible. Now you start looking like a fucking clown again.
Okay, so that's
the
Cheeto angle.
In the asshole.
Okay, let's argue that side of it.
Which is unbelievable. In the every time you shit, you probably throw up or you'd gag.
Oh no! I didn't
every
think
time.
Of that. I was just thinking, yeah, because for a second there, I was like, oh, yeah, I'll just take the taste buds in my asshole, because I don't have to taste. I can just eat food in my mouth,
yeah,
and just not taste it, and not have to worry about Cheeto dust. But then, like you said, every time you take a dump,
and probably
you taste it,
right?
That would be like someone taking a dump in your mouth every single day. I guess technically
multiple
you
times
taking
a
dump,
right? You ever wonder what diarrhea tastes like?
Oh man,
you're gonna find out.
Now I'm leaning back towards Cheeto dust.
I have a pro tip.
Okay.
I would do this. If I had taste buds in my asshole, I would fill my underpants up with like mashed potatoes and I'd just sit in it and just all day be pretty pumped.
Yeah.
I mean, you could probably do some chapstick, like rim it.
I was just thinking that.
Rim some Carmex,
ring
it up.
Cherry chapstick. Oh, then you gotta be real careful. You gotta be careful who you loan out your cherry chapstick to.
Yeah.
Right?
You gotta be real close.
Or somebody you just don't care for. That'd be a
good prank.
Good prank.
Mm-hmm.
Give somebody your asshole chapstick.
Minty suppository.
Right.
Ooh, yeah.
Toothpaste.
Toothpaste.
Brush your butthole.
And there's flavored lube. I guess you could just always have flavored lube in your butthole.
There's medical stuff too. Like you could take a shot that just numbed up all the taste buds. Or is that cheating?
That's probably cheating. And
it's a lot of that's a lot of doctor visits. I mean, you're gonna go insane at that point. Like I chop off my hands, I chop off my butt.
Right.
I'd have no butt. I wouldn't care anymore.
I don't think numbing your anus would be good, because then I feel like you could rupture stuff when you go to the bathroom. And how many times are you going to poop yourself? That's a recipe for like chronic sharts, because you just don't know.
Yeah.
You can't feel it.
And we've broken it down to like being disgusted every time you poop. Your colon's not like it's all fresh and dandy when you're not pooping. That's a fart. It's a fart basket.
Right. Right.
It's a little gas launcher down there.
You'd have to like constantly be gaping yourself to spray mint into your colon.
Or mashed potatoes.
Mashed potatoes.
Thanksgiving all the time.
What a weird infection you get. Like the doctor's like, this is a strange question, but have you been putting mashed potatoes in your butthole every day for the last couple of years? Funny you bring that up.
Stop me if I'm off base here. Is there gravy coming out your ass? But no, like literal gravy.
Is there literal turkey gravy
coming out your ass?
And a little bit of the stuffing.
Dark stuff, yeah.
Is there cranberry sauce?
In your asshole?
Why do you have Thanksgiving dinner in your butthole?
Be honest with me. I'm your doctor. Why is Thanksgiving in your butthole? Try to explain your way out of that.
Okay, so after really thinking about it.
Okay.
That way, I'm going to go Cheeto dust.
Going to go Cheeto dust.
What about you?
Oh, fuck, man. That's a tough one.
Mm-hmm.
The part of trying to shower, the insanity of never being able to get it off.
Right.
In the shower,
yeah,
just endless.
You always got
orange,
yep.
Like water.
Mm-hmm.
No more baths unless you have fucking gloves on.
You just acclimate to it.
I'm going butthole.
Okay, who's right? Is Cheetos right? Cheetos is wrong.
Mm-hmm.
What about butthole? God dang.
The butt is always right.
The butt's always right.
You knew that.
You learned it here first.
Thanks again, John. That was a lot of fun. And again, dumb@isbedumb.com if you want to send those in. Before we take a look at all the other dumb people in the world, as we've hinted to many times, we are stupid.
Mm-hmm.
We're stupid people.
I got a good one today.
Okay. Is we dumb? All right. Last week, I shared my Bluetooth porn story.
Yep.
What do you got for us this week, Danny boy?
This is recent, and I haven't told anybody about this yet because I was pretty embarrassed.
Okay.
I didn't tell Lindsay. I was just driving down to Central Idaho to see some family. On the way, needed gas. So uh-huh. That Chevron right down the street.
Okay.
I stopped there.
At the Piggies?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep, the little Piggies that they don't even serve anymore, the old barbecue place.
It's something. It just held on to the name. I guess probably legal issues.
Right, right.
I don't know.
So I have, obviously, I have an empty tank, put the gas nozzle in there. I'm looking at my phone, have it set to, automatic, whatever.
Right.
And then I hear the clink.
Okay.
And it felt like it had been going for a while. So okay. I hear the clink. Of the gas being over. So like, right. Yeah, whatever. Just put my phone away and just grab the nozzle and go to set it out. Full on spraying still. Like, it wasn't done. It was the person next to me. They were done. And I was so shocked by doing that I just held it. And it's full pressure. I'm spraying gas everywhere. I get it all over the side of my truck. So much gas on the side. Turn it off. I mean, there's gas all over the place.
You fucked it.
Mm-hmm. And I know that's kind of dangerous, like flammable. And I probably should have told somebody, but instead I just quickly threw it in there and I just kind of drove off as fast as I could and just let somebody else deal with it. I felt terrible.
I mean, what are you going to do?
I was so embarrassed.
What are you going to do besides like set it on fire? I'm set glad you got fire. Out of there before you made the, mm-hmm. the worst choice, which is blow up the gas station.
part of me was thinking about like I'm driving away and then I just see it explode in the background.
That'd be kind of cool. I mean,
okay, to be real honest,
you can be honest with me. I'm your
if
doctor.
If you did that and you're driving away and it literally exploded, like people died.
Yeah, the guy that fooled you is dead now,
mm-hmm.
which is his fault.
It's his fault. But there was other innocent people who also died. Do you tell anybody?
Oh, well.
Do you take that secret to your grave?
Oh, man.
Because you're going to go to jail.
You're going to get caught. So you probably turn yourself in.
That's right. Dang it.
Is it the
I'm
Wild
such
West?
A bastard. I was like, I probably keep it secret and just try to live with the guilt.
In my head, I'm like, there's cameras everywhere.
There's cameras everywhere.
They're good luck.
God.
You're caught. That's it. Especially with you and your license plate. Like
oh, yeah. My stupid license plate. I don't think we've talked about that here. It's so annoying.
It makes me every morning I pull in, it makes me so happy.
It looks like a vanity plate. I don't have a vanity plate, but it's the weirdest coincidence. I did get the custom license plate for Idaho. You can get like a fish because I first got my truck here. I was like, man, I want to go fishing. And I do go fishing sometimes.
I'm a fish all the time now.
Yep. Not as much as I would like, but I would like, I go sometimes. And so... I get the license plate in the mail, and it's AV1D. So it's not a vanity. Avid fisherman. It's avid right by a trout. So I look like the guy who all he fucking does is fish.
Yes, and no, I can't believe. No family, no job.
Mm-hmm.
Catch me at the lake, bro.
Yep.
Yep.
So when I go back from like a fishing spot empty-handed into my avid fisherman, I just feel like the biggest phony. I just feel like a guy who's went surfing one time and now I have like a palm tree license plate with Surf's Up.
Surf's Up. And a rack on top for your surfboard.
All I wear is O'Neill brand clothing and Hurley and all that.
And
you
live in Coeur d'Alene.
And I live in Coeur d'Alene. I feel like that version. I'm like,
right
God damn
there
it.
There the beach. I remember. Yeah, I used to bug you about that all the time.
Yeah.
I come into work at my house fishing last night. Like, I didn't fucking go. I was like, well, your license plate.
Right. You just get back from the fishing hole? No.
Your story reminded me
of
one of my funniest childhood memories that I could think of with my dad. My dad, as we've covered, not like the calmest guy in the world, but he's not like crazy, but he does get a little riled up.
Be honest. Do I remind you of your dad?
No.
Okay.
No way, man.
Because I know I lose my cool sometimes.
No. Okay. You're good. We were on a trip. I think we were going to Portland.
Okay.
Family trip. And we're stopped and it got my stepmom, me and my brother in the back seat and we're filling up for gas.
Okay.
And we're all just kind of, it was super, super windy, right?
Okay.
Really windy. And my dad goes out and he's putting gas in the side of the van, right?
Yeah.
And he's trying to fill it up and like it's not working. And then in true dad fashion, he holds it up to like.
Does he punch? Oh no.
To see if it worked.
Yeah.
And as soon as he pulled it, it went like, it went out and he just goes.
Yeah. In his own face?
He just goes,
he's furious.
Oh, goddamn. And we're in the car going, he can hear us laughing.
Oh, yeah.
And he's grabbing, paper towels or napkins out.
Just like, yeah, his eyes are probably burning.
His whole face just got covered, but then he started laughing.
Oh, okay.
But,
okay,
like, good. For a second, like, it shocked him so bad, he couldn't stop. He was, like, getting electrocuted. His hand tensed up, and the high gale force winds just covered him in gasoline.
That
and then everyone blew up.
That is, dude. And everyone died. And everyone died.
Everyone died. I just wanted.
Anyway. I just think about the trip after that where Lindsay hates the smell of gasoline.
Yeah, the whole
because it's so powerful, so pungent. I actually really like it.
Mm-hmm.
But
I don't mind it.
I don't mind. Yeah, I was just thinking about your dad. Like you can't when it's on your face. Not like wherever you guys had to drive to. You're reeking of gasoline that entire trip.
I mean, it was go to the bathroom in the gas station, shirt, you know, face wash,
right.
And it's gas though.
Yeah.
It's gas. It's very gassy.
Very gassy.
Unbelievable though. That's so funny. I picture you doing this.
Well, I was worried about Lindsay smelling it and then having to confess because whenever I fuck around with gasoline, she's like, what's that smell? Do you get,
are you on fire?
The last time she smelled it was when I burnt. Oh, you know what? I'm going to save that one. Never mind.
Okay.
That's another dumb story. Because that's real dumb. My mom got real angry at me recently.
Okay. I love that. That was good. Thank you for being vulnerable and making me laugh at your expense. let's laugh more at other people's expense.
Okay, good. All good. Right.
Dumb, dumb idiots.
Dumb. Dumb, dumb. Dumb. Dumb, dumb idiots.
You know, I found some good ones tonight.
Before you go, I forgot. Because I looked at my note. I was making a note for the next dumb thing I confess to. And then if you guys, for stand-up fans, my special Get Out of Here Devil is on Amazon Prime now.
Yeah,
So if you're a Prime member on Amazon, you can watch it for free.
Yeah.
And a lot of people have been watching it and rating it, which I appreciate.
And it's funny.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's all I got.
And if they don't care for you and how funny you are, I'm the devil.
And you're the devil. Joe is on the cover. Joe, it's me and Joe on the cover.
That was my moment.
That was super fun.
That was my big moment.
Mm-hmm.
Life will never get better than being a little devil on the riding you around the studio.
That was fun. When you said, like, if you don't like it, I was picturing, like, how just weird it would be if I just went into a pitch of, like, listen, a lot of people don't care for it. There's also Joe Coy, there's Burke Kreitz, there's a lot of good stuff on there. And I just, like, list all these other specials people should watch. A
bunch of Amazon originals.
Oh, like, the Amazon originals.
Go through.
They give that to the funnier people. I didn't get one. And then there's...
just a total humility pie. Just right. Like, damn.
Barely, but no, stop. Stop. It's okay.
Jesus Christ, dude. It's funny. Crying. Like, it could have been better. It could have been better. All right. Let's hop over to our first dumb, dumb idiot, shall we?
Yeah.
And this is dumb because of how little understanding these people just have of how the world works around them.
Okay.
Just completely oblivious to what's going on.
Okay.
Go ahead and bring it up on the screen, Zach. Thank you, sir. U.S. town rejects solar farm amid worries it would soak up all the energy from the sun.
Oh, my God.
This isn't a new article by any means.
Okay.
But it's new to me.
But it's not from The Onion. This is real.
This is real life. The town of Woodland, North Carolina, is in the spotlight this week after rejecting a proposal to rezone a section of land just outside its borders for the use of a solar farm. Three solar farms have already been approved in the area, but the local residents are seemingly not impressed. Scoff. The council defeated a motion for a rezoning on the area of U.S. Highway 258, my favorite highway in the country, by the way. Yeah, for an additional solar farm after the public comment period where members of the town could give their opinions.
Oh, boy.
And we'll get into them here in just a second. Boy. A retired science teacher, Jane Mann, said she was concerned about the rising risk of cancer deaths in the area, despite reports showing the cancer rates in North Carolina have fallen, classic, over the period of 2008 to 2012. After that, no one could tell her that the solar panels were not causing the cancer.
Right, and she's the science teacher.
No one came with the facts, so...
That's scary that she's the science teacher. Or retired, but whatever.
Sure, right. She was also concerned that photosynthesis would slow down to the solar panels, stopping the plants from growing in the solar farm field.
How is she the fucking science teacher?
What the fuck is going on?
I struggled in science.
Where are we?
I understand that you can't... What is she even talking about?
And she's demanding answers. She goes, I want to know what's going to happen. I want information. Enough is enough. I don't see the profit for the town. Fine.
Okay.
People come with hidden agendas until we can find if anything is going to damage the community. We shouldn't sign any paper, she added. Bobby Mann, not clear if related, but last name's about the same. I'm going to go out on a limb, say props.
Mm-hmm.
Said he was worried the local community would dry up. You're killing your town. He said, all young people are going to move out.
What?
I don't know.
Why?
Don't know
why? Why would they do that?
It goes on to say a couple more things, one of which I could agree with. Other residents were also reported calling the panels ugly or hideous.
Okay, fine.
As I said, they're worried about their property value declining because of it.
Okay.
Yeah, they're not beautiful.
Yeah, they're big.
But
okay, I get that
absolutely
part.
Absolutely blew my mind how you could be this disconnected. It's not, I don't understand the deep science of a solar panel.
Right.
But I understand it's not a fucking sun ray magnet.
Right.
It's not.
That's what I was thinking.
It's not sucking up the sun rays.
Exactly. That's the exact picture I had. That's hilarious. I mean, and I just don't understand how this former science teacher. Oh my God.
That scares me a little bit.
Yeah. Like, what the fuck was she teaching? Where I'm just picturing, like, in her brain, you have this giant area and the sun, like, it gives, like, five rays per acre. And then. And then if you put these solar panels, like, well, then it just bends, like you said, all the rays. It sucks. Like it would somehow, like you said, like it could be a magnet and suck in the rays. Yeah. And then all of the surrounding, you know, like vegetation is just dying. People are like, I don't understand. It's like they're not getting any sun.
And does she think it would be black? Like it gets darker? Like it starts, like the shadows get bigger around the solar?
Does she think it would be shade? I just picture like the doctor being like, "We got a rickets is out of control. We got a rickets epidemic."
Yeah,
I think rickets is caused by lack of vitamin D. But if I'm wrong on rickets, okay,
I'm with you.
I just picture like just vitamin D deficiencies one after another. It's those goddamn solar panels.
Yeah, sucking up all the sun.
Take all the sun in the entire county.
And just then like a bunch of tanners, like people that want to get tan, laying out solar panels, just baking.
Right,
you get scorched.
Wow, just what a crazy lack of understanding.
I know. It blew my mind.
And I'm not somebody who really gets it, but I mean.
Right. And it's fine if you don't understand it.
Oh, my God.
Just admit you don't understand it and leave it at that. Don't go marching down to your Woodland city council meeting and claiming that it's going to suck up all the photosynthesis opportunities.
Talk to somebody. Talk to somebody who's an expert. Talk to your psychiatrist.
First, go take some pills.
Because
you're fucking crazy.
And you're fucking crazy.
And then probably just get too tired and don't go to the city council meeting. But if you happen to make it.
Yeah. But before that, talk to somebody in that field. Ask some questions. It reminds me of people right now freaking out about 5G.
Oh, right.
I've heard a lot of people freak out about 5G. Not one of them has some kind of advanced degree in technology. Right. Not a single one.
Yep.
Frankly, everyone that I've talked to, they don't have either a degree at all or a degree in anything remotely close to that, but they are convinced that it's given us cancer. It's my favorite on the 5G is that it's spreading viruses.
It is.
Which is how the fuck do you think that this weird
virus— What do you think radio waves
just
are doing, bro?
Right, yeah. Do we just live in this sea of viruses, surfing on little radio frequencies?
Like ocean jet streams.
right.
I'm going to Kansas.
Oh,
going to get Debbie sick. Bye, guys.
That's terrifying.
Super terrifying.
I just picture the people running the council meeting just like in their heads being like, are you fucking kidding me?
Oh, go back to your science room, lady. Go teach my kids.
I feel like even in city council meetings, it should be fair. Like, you know, you got to be like nice and courteous to a point.
Mm-hmm.
But when somebody reaches a certain level of ignorance, it should be socially acceptable for when that lady asks that question. We're going to need you just to shut up and sit down. You're dumb. Next question.
Or just go over and like flip her table over.
Like that. Shut up and sit down, dummy. And flip her table over. Anybody else?
Anybody else have anything? Your husband's here? Oh, you guys aren't related? Flip his table over?
Does anybody who's not a total fucking idiot
have
any concerns?
Say? Yeah, exactly. But I did get the hideous point, which I brought up.
Solar
panels, you know, they're working out for an alternative energy source and they're doing pretty good.
Yeah, yeah.
They just got to get cheaper. I mean, that's all a thing, right? But I was thinking about other things that maybe I just didn't like because they were ugly when I was reading this article. And to me, cargo shorts.
Oh, not a big fan of cargo. Lindsay.
Very practical.
Lindsay hates them.
So many pockets.
So many pockets.
But all I can think about every time I see cargo shorts is inside the pockets having more cargo shorts. Like you're a walking fisherman's tackle box. You have endless lure positions.
It's like Inception cargo shorts edition.
Yeah, exactly.
Cargoception.
Needs a pocket? And I got it. And six extra pairs of cargo shorts, all stuffed with other cargo shorts.
Oh my God.
It's an endless thing, man.
Whenever I think of cargo shorts, I think of my kid's grandpa, my ex-wife's father, the sweetest man.
Okay.
Very nice guy. I've never met someone who loves a pocket even as close to as much as this guy. He is fascinated and he has any stuff. So he always has cargo pants.
Okay.
And like special, I don't even know where the fuck he gets them. It'll have like extra pockets inside the pants for like sneaky stuff.
Yeah.
Then he'll have a shirt with a variety of pockets and he wears a jacket, even when it's hot, that has plenty of secret pockets. And it's like this, and he wears a fanny pack.
Yeah.
So he has so many things and it's just ridiculous. Like, I will say sometimes it'll come in handy where you're like, you'll be working on something. Like I gotta go grab an Allen wrench. You're like, oh, hold on.
Right.
And then he'll like go into one of his 75 pockets and have like a little miniature Allen wrench set. Like, I'm like, are you kidding me?
It reminds me of my son, Ezra, who we've talked about high functioning autism.
Yes.
Like if like that, his thing was pockets.
Right.
Like his thing is clocks and fans,
fans
and like
things
that he'll walk in, he'll know within 4 seconds how many fire alarms they are, what brand they are.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like if what their settings are. And he just knows everything about that. But it's like if pockets, like he shows up and he just comes over and like, oh, like starts like feeling your pockets, like checking out, like checking little secret pockets. He just has to do it.
Yeah.
That's when he enters a room.
Yeah. Yeah.
Something he has to do. So I got another story for you.
Okay, I like stories.
Ready to move on here?
I am.
All right. And this one is absolutely, it's crazy. Okay. It's crazy that this could happen. And the reason why I picked it is because it's your job to literally declare a person is 100% dead before you haul them off to the funeral home, right?
Yeah.
And like, how could you mess that up?
Right.
That is the one thing that you're supposed to do.
It's the most important job.
And in this situation, they completely fucked it. Zach, go ahead and bring it up. Zach is lightning fast.
Are you sick
of me yelling at you, Zach?
Not one bit.
Okay. Zach has a new little button thing. Is that working?
Now he's gonna, I can't yell him ever again.
He has the fast buttons.
Yeah, we got a stream deck for anybody that's a nerd out there. All right, so they thought she was dead. Then she woke up at the funeral home.
Oh, my God.
So Tamisha, Bocamp, 20, was taken to the funeral home in a body bag. When she arrived, a worker discovered her breathing with her eyes open.
Oh, my God.
Michigan woman who was declared dead by paramedics on Sunday was discovered alive hours later by the funeral home worker who was preparing to embalm her body.
What?
A lawyer to her family said. The lawyer, Jeffrey Fager, and the woman, Tamisha Bocamp, was born with cerebral palsy. She requires constant care since birth, they said Tuesday. I believe her relative fragile condition contributed to the false belief by the authorities that she had died.
Man.
He added, I mean, they're getting a lawyer. They're doing all this kind of stuff. Around 7:30 a.m. on Sunday, paramedics responded to a call of an unresponsive woman at home in Southfield, Michigan, northwest of Detroit. And, I mean, that's the gist of it. And that's all you need to know, really.
Now, call me crazy. Okay, now I'm just thinking about this.
Okay.
Because I scanned down further in the article, and they were just talking about like this, there was some line in there about due to her fragile condition, right, you know, that added to it. So that leads me to believe that she has a faint pulse, which is like, okay, sure. Let's say she has a real faint pulse. I would just think like, don't you just get like a mirror and put it right over her mouth and nose, and wouldn't that fog up?
I mean,
and if
anything.
It does that, I mean, because if she was alive, even if her heartbeat is faint, she is for sure breathing.
There's something
for
there.
Sure
breathing. There is something happening. There's got to be a sign somewhere. I'm guessing they just didn't. They didn't take the proper steps.
I don't like to play armchair quarterback.
Neither do
often,
I, for
often
sure.
With like medical stuff.
Right.
But I'm just going to go ahead and say that those paramedics fucking suck.
Yeah, they did not do the correct job.
There is no awards on their mantle.
Mm-hmm.
There's no like you're the paramedic of the year for this county. Like you just got a key to the city.
Yeah.
Like, oh my God, we're so lucky to have you.
Yeah.
Nope.
Yeah.
Like these, and then the coroner. That just,
how scary,
what?
How, I mean, everybody had to agree. It's like, it was just, had to have been like a trickle down waterfall thing.
Right.
One person did a sloppy job.
Yeah.
And they said, yeah, she's dead. And then everyone was
and
like,
everybody else was lazy. Dead. Like, yeah, no, she's dead. Yeah, fine.
Probably totally dead. And the cerebral palsy doesn't help. In my mind,
right.
It says do a better job of being way more careful.
Yes.
And do more intensive care.
Yes.
On this particular person.
Yeah. If you know somebody has
the normal signs that you would check are not going to be the same.
Right. If you know somebody that has a medical condition where they're not able to verbalize certain things to you until then, yes, you have to go even further to make absolute, you know, like be absolutely certain.
Yeah.
That you're correct. That this somebody was being lazy.
Can you imagine?
A couple people were being lazy.
Being the guy in the funeral home or woman that was about to embalm her.
Oh my God.
And she's like, she's breathing and her eyes are awake inside the body bag.
And when she
had to find a new profession.
And when she first.
You're not going back. That's what?
When she first starts to come to, I was just thinking, I just started rewatching The Strain. I love it.
I love it.
It's like a vampire's, the Strigoi. It's in the first season, episode one, when this disease gets going, if I'm spoiling it for you, well, you've had 7 fucking years to watch it.
It's your fault at this
your
point.
Your fault.
Yeah.
It's your fault. But they start to reanimate. Like, you know, like this guy's on the examination. Right. And there's been other scenes in the movies when that happens. But like a real life version of that, I mean, just for a second, I wonder if in his head, just for a second at least, he was like, oh my God, it's a zombie attack.
This is it.
Or like some kind of undead.
He grabs his bug
and then he remembers he's a man of science, whatever. But like just for a second, he's like, oh my God, it's zombies! And then kind of calms down.
He grabs his bug out bag. He's ready to hit the fucking road. He's out of there. But I swear, that would be it. I feel so bad for him.
Oh
I really
God.
Do. I really do. But this did remind me, this guy messed up his job so bad that I was thinking to myself, like, how bad have I messed up on the job?
Okay.
And this story, given that she had cerebral palsy,
right,
reminded me of a story where I fucked up real bad.
Okay, I want to hear about it.
And I'm nothing bad like happened.
Yeah.
But I, growing up, helped run a sports camp for kids with disabilities.
Okay.
Like
okay.
all through college. So 4 or 5 years, right? Down in my hometown of Sun Valley, Idaho.
Who died and did you get in legal trouble?
Yes. I am running from the law right now.
Okay.
My name is actually Chad Miller or something, right?
Sure.
So one of the days, we were going on a trip to a lake. That was probably, it's like an hour and a half drive.
Okay.
And we have a young girl that had to be in a wheelchair.
Okay.
And I have my CDL. I'm driving the short bus and we're going out on the trip and it's full. Like we have our councils and stuff like that.
Commercial driver license, right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So we load her in and then you get her inside. And what you're supposed to do is not only lock the wheelchair wheels.
Oh, no.
There's also straps that you're supposed to like, there's like a rail on the floor.
Yeah.
And you have like kind of like ratchet straps to tie the wheelchair in.
Yeah.
I forgot to do that and just drove.
No. Did she fly to the back of the bus?
No. Luckily, I locked the wheels and we made it there.
And she didn't tip off?
No. And we made it there. It's not like
you lucked out.
Dude, you kidding me? Lucked out. I felt so bad. Like, I mean,
that could have gone real wrong.
Remember, I went back and I like leaned down to like do the straps.
Oh,
and
then
I
was shit.
Like looked around. And I was like seeing if any, I had like a lot of good friends that were the counselors.
Right.
I was like, did you guys find it? Like, I wanted to ask them, but I was like, well, they didn't.
Right.
So, and then in my head, I'm like, I didn't do it. I clearly remembered. I was like, oh my God. I was like, let's go. And just got her off the bus and never told anybody till right now.
Oh man. Well, you lucked out. You lucked out. No one got hurt.
That was a big mistake. That still scares me.
My worst mistake was about the same time in my life as that one was for you. I was just out of college and I was working as a counselor at this residential treatment center.
I love that. Why do I love that? I love that vision so much.
I have numerous stories. From this, I'll share one today. This will be fodder for a while because I did a lot of stupid things. But I was a residential treatment center, and, you know, and it's like runaways. It's like generally 13 to 17 year olds having, you know, problems or whatever like that. And I committed like one of the biggest mistakes. I am supervising, so I'm making sure that these kids, a lot of them have criminal records. They got things going on.
Yeah.
I fell asleep, and they raided the medical cabinet, and they got a bunch of drugs, and they were never recovered. And I had a severe talking to.
You still got to keep your job?
I got a formal written up. If I got another one, I was going
to
be fired.
You should go to jail right now. Go turn yourself in.
I think some of the kids got a hold of some opioids. And of course, the kids aren't going to confess and like give them back.
This shouldn't be funny, but it's really funny.
So I just fucking fell asleep. Oops. I was bored. I sat down and I was going to quote unquote rest my eyes.
Yeah.
And I'm sure I was tired because I was probably fucking hammered the night before.
You sure didn't fall asleep and just be like, have at it. And then point to the drugs.
Cut me in a slice.
Hate my life. I'll see you.
I don't care.
Meet me on the corner after we're done with this shit. I mean, that's bad.
That's pretty good. Bad. So they're angry.
We make mistakes, but you know what I haven't done?
What?
Actually mistaken somebody who was alive for dead.
Me neither.
Haven't done that yet.
Never done that.
That's pretty dumb.
I did say a really inappropriate thing recently about, I love it when you're testing out your humor. With somebody that you've hung around with some, but not a lot.
Okay.
And I was on a boat just the other day with dinner with one of our friends here, who's a great, great guy.
Yeah.
And he was sharing a thing on the water about how he had seen a dead body when he was a kid. And it was like this traumatic thing, you know, him and his dad.
Yeah.
And she was floating in there. And it got quiet for a second. And I just go, was she hot? And he did not laugh. No, he said, I'm gonna pretend I didn't hear that.
And that's why we host the show together and it's not with him. Can you imagine?
He was correct. He was correct. But
if she goes, no, she's ugly.
Just ran with it? No.
I don't know. She was face down, bro. I couldn't tell. Great ass, though.
DTF. Are you kidding me?
Okay. Let's move on to the dumbest thing that I saw this week. Apocalypse pending! There is not a lot of setup for this.
Okay.
But this is true. This was this past weekend right here in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho.
Okay.
We got invited over to a little kind of, I mean, it's like a retirement kind of community off Northwest Boulevard that I didn't even know existed.
You and your family?
Yeah.
Got invited to
a nice lady. Oh. No, one of my daughter's best friends, her mom's mom. Oh. Anyway, like we're just trying to get access to a pool.
I get you.
So we got access to the pool.
Okay. Okay.
So we go there and we park and I get out and I turn my head.
Yeah.
And I see this.
Oh, so this is from your camera.
This is my picture. And what we're looking at right now, it says speed limit 5.5 miles per hour.
Is that a joke?
No, they're everywhere. It's not one. These signs are up and down. I saw at least 20 of them.
And it's a real, they want you to go no fast. Who? What?
Can you imagine?
Get out of here.
The meeting that had to happen to set up this 5.5, where you have like the guy leading it. He goes, okay,
all right,
one last order of business. We got to set the speed limit, you know, and you got Amanda, and she goes 5, and he goes, I walk faster than fucking 5.
Right.
get out of here. Next guy's like, six? Jesus, Lightning McQueen. Wow.
Whoa, easy.
Wait, NASCAR track? Easy, Dale.
All right, Leadfoot.
Easy. Let it up, Sonic.
Right, right, right.
Okay, we'll meet in the middle. 5.5.
I was picturing two people where he just, like, they couldn't come to an agreement.
Yeah.
Like Amanda is just like, no, it's got to be 5 miles. Every other retirement community, it's 5 miles an hour.
I'm moving out. I'm packing my shit.
And then Karen is like, six. I think it's six. And neither one will back down. It's five. Not six. And then finally, like, you know, whoever's running, it's fucking 5.5. It's 5.5. Are you happy?
We have other things to talk about. Right. It's not that important. There's no half on the
we got put into order. We got mattress covers to put out.
We got a bingo party at the pool, and we got to get this straightened out before Friday. Right. It's a big day.
Right.
5.5.
5.5 it is.
Print it. Get the signs right now. Don't care.
That is.
How did that happen? It's so ridiculous.
That happened due to, if it really isn't a joke, which I don't think it is.
No, I mean, it wasn't.
That's not what you'd usually do where you do a joke.
In a joke place, a joke factory. Right, that's right. Where you do a joke.
But not at a retirement community where for the speed limit.
And they're mad there. That's got to be like the most lighthearted old people.
Right.
I mean, there's no way.
Whoever
that's not funny.
Whoever made that decision is beyond anal retentive.
Yeah.
Like that person is just like, what?
Six.
Mm-hmm. And they just take their jobs so seriously.
Mm-hmm. And they waste.
Which is a pet peeve of mine, by the way.
well aware.
When people get so anal retentive about a certain facet of their job.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God. I went off so hard one time. At this hotel clerk.
All right.
Because it was a dead hotel. Oh. I had taken a red eye flight
to
like, I don't know, Kansas City or somewhere, coming early for some radio I was doing or whatever. Like, I don't even remember why. But anyway, I get in early. So I get to the hotel at like 11 a.m. Check-in is at, I don't know, 1 p.m.
Kay.
At this place.
Right.
But it is dead. There's no, and so I just go there.
Tumbleweed through the lobby.
Tumbleweed. And I was like, hey, and I've done this all the time. It's like, hey, you know, I know I'm early, but is it okay? I'll take any room, you know, whatever. Can I just go ahead and check in?
Being real nice and pleasant.
It's check-in is at 1 p.m. And, you know, points at the sign. And I was like, nah, I know. I know that's what the policy is.
I can read.
Yep.
Sir.
Mm-hmm. I travel a lot. I do this all the time. Yeah. It's usually not a problem. You know, I'll take any room at all if I could just get in. Sir, check-in is at 1 p.m. And so then I just go up. I'm like, you mean to fucking tell me? That every single, like, it just, you can't bend. You can, and then the manager comes out and she goes, sir. You know, that kind of thing. The manager, and real Karen, this manager comes out. Sir, it takes our cleaning team until 1 o'clock to get the rooms ready. And so then I just go, I'm like, so you mean to tell me that no rooms are ready at 12:55 and then all the rooms are ready at 1 p.m. Because I'm pretty sure they clean them one at a fucking time.
As they move down.
At that point, I'm done. At that point, I have to wait. There's no, now I'm just getting in my shots.
Yeah, exactly.
Since I have to wait.
Yeah, because there's a whole mafia of cleaning ladies. Mm-hmm. Like, and go! And they go, like all shoot through the floors.
Right. I picture like a horse race. Like they're in the beginning gates, and then they throw up the gates,
spinning,
and they're just so
spinning
fast.
Like spray bottles and shit, like, you know, squeaking on their little rubber gloves and stuff.
Right.
The carts, you know, stretching.
And then just as the clock's ticking like 10 seconds to one, just sweat pouring out of everyone, scrubbing the last spots, and then throwing their hands up at the buzzer.
Yeah,
rooms are ready at once.
Yay! Next level that would be if they had to compete for their job, so they had to push each other out of the way while they're running down the hallways to clean these. But 5.5 miles an hour. That's great.
5.5 miles an hour.
Yeah. So we'll put this picture up. Oh, yeah. And by the way, before we move on to One Star Heroes.
Yeah.
I did want to point out, thanks to our listener requests.
Yeah.
Any additional photos, like outside of Dumb Dumb Idiots, outside of the articles, but any additional photos or videos like from internet, another segment we'll get to, we're going to post those in the description.
Oh, okay.
People
cool.
are very interested in like following up, making sure they could check it out and see it.
Great.
I think the chicken arms kind of sparked it.
Yeah, like,
I gotta see this. That's and we awesome. Were like, oh, sorry, we posted it up way late. So we'll get better at that. But you'll see that in the description. Are you ready to?
I'm ready.
Get riled up.
This is gonna be a fun one.
All right. One Star Heroes.
I get no respect in real life. Always am upset. So I let them know I hate them on the internet. Yeah.
All right. I'm pumped. What's
up? Okay. So today, usually I go to a business that has like 5 stars all the time and then show the 1 stars.
Okay.
Today, I'm just going to a business where no one should expect should expect a five star experience.
Okay.
And that people do one stars. So there's not very many adult film theaters left in the North America, but there are a few.
That just made me snort. I'm so fucking excited to see these.
At least I was laughing so hard. I was crying this morning looking at these reviews.
I mean, I snorted before I even read anything, so I'm pumped too.
So we're going to start. I had talked about this on Time Suck actually a long time ago, but this is more of the appropriate format for it.
Okay.
Studs Theater. Closed due to COVID, but it's 2.5. So it's in West Hollywood.
All right.
And it's not well rated, but mm-hmm. it is what it is.
Mm-hmm. It's, yeah, I mean, dick's out there. What do you expect?
So here's the reviews. James M. writes, or James B., sorry.
James, sorry.
Sorry, yeah. Sorry, James. One star. Last night, I returned to being a twink, and I'm at 48. through curiosity, I went to Studs Movie House on Santa Monica. It stank. Everything falling apart, including the clients loitering and slithering around the place like a collection of apathetic turtles on barbs. I paid $20 to get in. I might as well burnt the $20. I'd have gotten more pleasure from this act. If you're into the daddies of daddies or have grandfather fetish, you may enjoy it. In the name of dignity, don't go. You'll need antidepressants on exit and question your very existence on this planet of ours. Okay, so that's...
Your expectations were too high, James.
And then this next one is worse expectations. So same theater.
All right.
Felissa R.
Okay.
So she's in West Hollywood. And if you've never been to West Hollywood, I live not too far from it. It is, basically like the highest percentage of homosexual couples like in per capita essentially.
Yeah.
Of probably any neighborhood in all of America.
Which also means in my brain I hear mm-hmm. that and I go, it's a really probably fun place to hang out.
Oh yeah. Super fun bars.
It's gonna be a blast.
Super like friendly people.
Capitol Hill in Seattle.
Yeah.
So much fun.
Mm-hmm. No, it's awesome. It's awesome. But if you go to an adult theater there, you're crazy to expect to cater to heterosexuals.
Yeah.
That just shows that you have no concept of where you are.
Mm-hmm.
And so Felissa R, one of these people, one star. Okay. Unfortunately, not the right place to visit looking for a movie porn theater with more discrepancies, which doesn't even make sense.
Yeah.
All they played in their four rooms was man on man. That's bullshit. I went with my spouse looking for clean, nice environment. And this is my favorite. Everyone in theater jacking off. Or practically naked. Not a safe, clean place to visit. For $20, could have watched free dirty porn on my phone. Not worth our time. Of course everyone is jerking off. It's a porn theater. What do you possibly expect?
What do you think is happening there?
People quietly watching just fucking dicks and butts so hard as they just enjoy popcorn and like, hey, can I get you a little more Coke? I'm going to go grab another Coke.
Want something? Like suit and tie?
Suit and tie?
Bouquet of flowers?
That is just like...
What do you think is going on?
That drives me crazy where it's like, where do you think you are?
It's back to the solar panel disconnect.
Right. Like
you just don't understand anything around you.
Yeah. You're just going
your world. That's it.
And it's places... It is like seedy. Even the people that describe it as like the five star, it's like... There's nothing like when you see it on the street, no part of you should think like, oh, this is going to be extremely sterile.
Yeah.
This is going to be a well-maintained establishment. I bet their snacks are delicious. You're going there to fuck and to jerk off and to get and to like there's every part of every seat is stained. Uh-huh. Like if you took a black light, the entire place would be bright.
You have to put on like those glasses that you wear after you get your eyes dilated.
Right.
That's what you need to have.
The whole, like literally there's not a faded spot. It's just a glowing every single corner. There's cum on the ceiling.
Right. Yeah. And what I don't understand is one of my favorite parts about going to these kind of theaters mm-hmm. is slip sliding like down the little aisleways.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, that's part of it. Like, it's fucking a little cum slide.
It's like a little slip inside.
What, you look at your little ticket, mm-hmm. you're like, what? Row F? And just, zip on down.
Your idea gave me the most disgusting visual of like a wedding train, like when you're and people are throwing rice. It's like that kind of thing, except for cum shots. Like, you're just walking down the aisle of a theater and you're just getting hit.
It's good to be
left
welcome
and right.
Back.
Ah, hey, guys. Good to see everybody.
Welcome back, Mark. I got it in my eye.
I have the theme song to Cheers. Going in my head, everybody knows your name. It's like you're Norm going up to the bar, you know, hey Norm, except it's just like so much just jizz.
Hey, like high fives or good shots. You get a little shield out before you head in.
Well, I have a few more quick ones.
All right, let's do it.
Because that got me thinking about some highlights from other theaters. This next one is Cinema L'Amour.
Ooh.
In Montreal.
Okay, I haven't seen it, but the name leads me to believe it. Okay, now I see it. Never mind.
So yeah, two-star, you know, it's kind of a seedy adult theater. Well, this guy I love on, this is Google, where there's more reviews. It's better reviewed here. But I love Hakim Pachez. It's translated, so it makes the language a little more funky from French.
And we're probably more fun to read.
Oh, it's so fun. Okay. I went there yesterday for the first time, and honestly, it was not famous. Okay. That's a weird way to start. You expect it. What does that even mean? I expect it. When I walk into an adult theater that claims to be world famous, I'm sure there was a sign somewhere. The world famous Cinema L'Amour. Like, oh, nope.
Reminds me of Elf. Like, world's best coffee. Congratulations. Right, when he walks in, you did it.
You did it. Okay, the film was good, but the other customers, who first off are only old men, although it's a couple's day, and seriously have no respect. The best example that I can give would be that yesterday, while I was watching the film, that I did nothing to encourage someone to come see me, an old man put himself behind the bench on my right, took out the package, and started playing afterwards. And even if I told him very clearly, said no to starting to bring his thing closer and closer to my face. And then I had to play the musical chair for the entire remaining time of the projection to get rid of the old pigs. So I love that this guy won't leave. There's a dude clearly jerking off right behind him, like dick by his face. And he's just like, nah, I'm just going to go. This is disrespectful. So I'm going to move a little bit further down the aisle. And then the old man's like, eh, eh, and he's like jerking off a little bit more. Like this jerk-off gremlin.
Come here, Hakim. Come out to get you.
I paid my money. I'm going to watch the whole film.
I'm not leaving. They're leaving.
I won't confront him, but I find this very disrespectful.
That's like my new kind of, I guess, picture a new serial killer. Like that dude that follows you around just jerking.
Come on, sit down.
Sit down.
Anywhere you sit, I'm there.
Yeah. And you just don't leave?
Yeah, he can't.
Some guy has a knife, like, in a park, and you just keep going to different park benches?
And he's always
I'm
there.
I'm going to stab you. I'm going to stab you in the neck. God dang it.
Sit still.
Yeah.
That's my... Anyway. That's what I'm thinking about, and we'll continue to think about.
Okay.
Until the movie is made.
That's a fun character. That's a fun character.
Send a budget. I'll make it.
Okay, so one more quick highlight. Now we're going to go to San Francisco.
Okay.
Feel more adult. And this is
this
not
for, like,
an adult
people
theater.
That don't feel adult? It's like for teenagers.
Feel more adult.
It sounds like a church camp.
This one is a sex shop, so it's not technically an adult theater. It came up when I was searching for adult theaters, and I saw this one review, and I just really wanted to share it.
All right.
So this is actually more traditional. This is the 4.5 stars, you know, well rated, 128 reviews, and then this is just the way it's written, the weirdest review.
All right.
Lawrence J, 1 star. I'm a student at a local university, not far from this establishment. And came one day hoping to inquire about their array of sexually pleasurable toys. Already I don't like them. Very pompous way to write this.
Yeah, we're going to get some of this going.
I thought I had found the perfect dildo, as it had skin texture and was battery powered. Okay. It was also waterproof for usage in the jacuzzi.
Yay!
However, when I was using it with my non-binary partner, we were both electrocuted severely. Ouch! Exclamation point. Ouchie! Oochie!
Ooh, boy!
Because I know some people are into this kind of stuff, I shall not kink shame. But I don't like pain or high medical bills. Electrocution was not advertised as a feature of the otherwise pleasurable and fun toy. I have contacted my lawyer. I love how this dumb son of a bitch, like, writes this as if there's a chance that it was supposed to do that.
Supposed
and they just forgot to write it. Like, on the packaging, they're like, oh yeah, by the way, this is going to electrocute the fucking shit out of you in a jacuzzi.
There's 5 speeds. It's 5 speeds, and it's also an electric bomb, like, on the side. Like, you get flicked through, you never know. Oh. Like, one of those joke handshake things that's going to zap you. It says the same thing. You get past that 5 vibe setting, that rhythm, and it just, like,
zap you.
Just zap your little.
And this Lawrence is so PC, I couldn't hang out with this person for 30 seconds.
What's she even doing in the sex shop?
Right, what's it? Yeah, get why are you there? And especially when you write it like... I love even in a complaint about being electrocuted in a jacuzzi. You're like, listen, I'm not trying to kink shame.
Right.
That's like if you got us. I don't know. I'm trying to think
what
to compare that to.
Fetish.
Like if you got if somebody in that if you complained that I don't know at a going back to the adult theater, you had a private room and somebody burst into the room and beat the fucking shit out of you and took your money. They just mugged you.
I know some people are into this.
Right. And then you complain. Listen. I don't want to kink shame, but I didn't want to get my fucking face smashed in and have my money taken by a total stranger
and that could
bounced
be for
off
you.
The wall.
That could be for you. It's not for me. This is amazing.
This person's so worried about saying the wrong thing.
Mm-hmm.
Just the language they use.
Just dancing.
Grow the fuck up, Lawrence.
God damn.
God.
Reminded me of one I saw that was for a video arcade, I think in Edmond over by Seattle, yeah. Where it's the opposite, where a guy gave it 5 stars.
Yeah.
It was one of the funniest things I've ever read. I don't know what we were doing looking at it.
Just a glowing review.
Just loved it. He was so pumped. He didn't have to hang his clothes up. Like, he just throw them wherever he wanted to. He said the selection was amazing. Like, yeah. they had Biker Bang 6.
Oh,
and he
nice.
Wanted to watch it, and it was right there for him.
You should be happy going into one of these places.
The screen worked.
Yeah.
Which just gives you, like, on the mm-hmm. off chance of how shitty these things probably are normally. Like, he was pumped. And all he described a closet with a TV. And that's, like, that was high life.
Perfect, perfect.
High life for him.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
He's doing it.
I think this is adult. If you just got to go with the right frame of mind. I mean, I just picture, ideally, you walk in the door and you have, like, the track pants with the buttons that you can just rip off. And no underwear. You just walk into one of these places and you just rip it off and you're already rock hard and you just start jerking. Like, right as you're ordering, you're jerking off already. And everybody else, the cashier, he's jerking off as he takes your money. And then everyone's fucking high-fiving. You got one hand in your dick, another hand high-fiving people. Everyone's so happy. Oh my God! Total freedom!
And whatever mm-hmm. you order, they like really coolly flick it to you as you head into the into the closet.
Yep.
Catch, you know, whatever, anal cum dumpster
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
26,
mm-hmm.
and you just go, snack it, and thumbs up.
Yep.
And right in there. And you're out 2 seconds later because you've been beaten off for 20 minutes already.
And there should be a sign somewhere, when you're done coming, please give us 5 stars. And it should just be a bunch of just dude after dude, just jerking, finish, god, fucking great.
Come out, guy puts a robe on you, mm-hmm. like it's just the...
It worked.
Top notch. They give you a shave.
Uh-huh.
I love that. That was a very enjoyable One Star Heroes.
Oh, good. Yay.
So a bunch of naughty bad stuff.
Yeah.
And we're going to do what we do and flip it around.
Okay.
And look at some good stuff.
I like good stuff.
Sliver of Hope.
Sliver of Hope.
I like that. It's so emotional.
I'm going to play a music bed right now. It's called Fun Rock. That's fun.
It's fun.
That's fun rock.
Yeah. I like
All
fun
right.
Rock.
Bring it up on the screen here, Zach.
Zach, bring it up!
I got him one time because he wasn't lightning fast.
Son of a bitch! Yeah,
fuck you, bro!
Oh, whoa! Man makes good on 1992 handshake, splits $22 million jackpot with his friend.
Wow.
How cool is this? I've
that
done this
is
with
awesome.
Friends. Where if I were to win, I fully intend on holding it up.
Yeah, I bet so you. I don't doubt for a second you would.
I'm just happy to see this, that he did it. So a Wisconsin man proved his devotion as a friend by making good on a 28-year-old handshake promise of splitting his $22 million Powerball jackpot with his longtime bunny.
Oh, my God.
Thomas Cook told Wisconsin lottery officials that learning the Powerball ticket he bought from Synergy Coop in whatever that place is, Menomonee?
Yeah. Oh, my God. Menomonee.
I tried to look it up. Was a $22 million winner. Made him quickly recall a deal he made with his friend Joseph Feeney in 1992.
Wow.
Like, immediately thought about that. And that's what I love. Like, he didn't get talked into it, have a lot of thought. Just a second, he was like, yep, I'm doing this. I'm splitting it.
I wonder if that guy forgot about it. Does it say?
I don't know. Let's get into it. I did not see it when I read it the first time.
Yeah.
I promise you that. Cook said the two men shook hands and agreed that if either of them ever won the Powerball jackpot, they'd split the winnings. I'm guessing he somewhat would vaguely remember that either way.
Yeah.
Especially if he won. You'd probably be like, oh, yeah, I remember. Yeah, you told me that.
Yeah.
He called me and said, are you jerking me, bobber?
Are you jerking my bobber?
Are you jerking my bobber?
You know how I know that term?
Oh, yeah, because you're
I'm an avid fisherman. I probably say that 3 times a day.
Yeah,
that's one of my catchphrases. Are you kidding me?
We go out
are you jerking my bobber?
we go out to lunch, and you go to the tackle shop.
Are you tugging my power bait?
What are you doing here, little worm?
What are you doing, worm? What are you doing?
What are you fishing with? Like, everything you do in life is fishing terms?
Are you tying my fly? Come on. Sorry.
You dunking my stick?
What are you doing here? What's going on here?
Cook and Feeney, who took the lump sum option for their payouts, each received about $5.7 million after federal and state taxes. Mm-hmm. Cook said the money inspired him to put in his 2 weeks' notice and retire. Oh. He and Feeney, who had already retired previously, said the money will allow them to spend more time with their families. We can pursue what we feel comfortable with, Cook said. I can't think of a better way to retire.
Oh, my God. I hope those guys go celebrate at one of those adult theaters I was just talking about.
Yeah, exactly.
They just got over, like, you know, $5 million.
It's covered in power bait.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, going man. In there just...
Mm. Just a great, just fishing and jerking.
Got anything with bass?
You got anything bass-related to watch? Oh, good for them, though.
Got chicks on boats in here, like little small fishing boats and kind of tippy and slow.
That's amazing.
I know.
That's very heartwarming. You know what? I read about a very similar story today. It's the same thing.
Okay.
But I think it just happened. It was Nicola, I think is the name of the company. It's like Nikola Tesla.
Yeah.
There's Tesla, and now there's the another one that hasn't made any trucks yet, but they're going to make electric trucks called Nikola. And the guy had made, I don't know if there's a formal deal like that, but the guy who runs it, I can't remember his name, I think it's a Utah-based company, and the CEO founder wanted to reward the first 50 employees who I guess took a big risk and low pay to work with him. And they did that for like 5 years. You know, he got really great minds, innovative, these scientist guys. He just gave them a preposterous, their shares have been soaring.
Okay.
And he gave 50 employees a preposterous amount of shares valued at $5 million for each employee.
Oh, that's so...
50 people were each given $5 million.
And I know you, and I know that you would promise me that same thing right now,
live
on air.
Yeah, if I...
Do it.
If I give 50 million... Okay, that's fine. If I get 50, then I gotta give you 5 million.
Yeah,
That's awesome, man.
All right, well, let's move on to the next segment here.
I'm excited about this one. I like weird. There's products, right?
There's some products. It's actually more just videos and then one random website.
Okay,
but
I'm fine with whatever.
It's gonna blow your mind.
Okay,
this is where we just kind of find. Well, the internet never stops giving you the gifts, like all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
No matter what it is, whether it's something weird for sale or just like a video you have to watch.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
We make room for that because it's very important.
Yes,
and it's called To You from Internet.
The internet has all sorts of neat things. Anything you want can be yours. Let's take a peek, together, as a couple. To you, from internet.
From the department of who the what fuck.
Okay.
Is where we're going to go with this one. And I will set it up by saying that it is a tradition that has been handed down in China.
Okay.
Where it started with training their military to better work together.
Like okay.
This is where it started.
That's where it started.
And then it progressed, and now people still hold it, keep the tradition going today by doing these what's called board races. Footboard races. Zach, go ahead and bring it up here. So it's exactly what you might think it is, but it's just like, what are you guys doing? How does this even happen?
What?
So right now, it's just like a board, like a shot glass ski with straps on it. And you have to run races with your foot locked into it.
Yeah, it's just a big 2x4. A
big train of people. Like, how far would we make it?
Not far. Not far.
I'd pick up one. Oh. Can you imagine how hard you're going to fall if you fuck up?
Imagine if you like blow your ACL or you blow a knee from doing this, and then that's the story you have for the rest of your life.
You wouldn't just blow your ACL. You'd blow all your friends' ACLs, too.
Yeah, because for the people listening, it's three people to a team.
And they have five. Like, they have longer footboards.
Because this one, it's like, it's like a, I don't know, what, like a 6 foot long 2x4 with three straps on each one. And then, that's so...
Isn't that crazy?
No, thank you.
Had no idea this even existed, but
it reminds me
cool.
of something I did as a kid.
Right.
It reminds me of, what would they call it? It's probably some horrible term. It's like, but when they tied your, like, so my left leg would be tied to somebody else's right leg.
Right. Yeah. What was that called?
And it would be a race.
Do the run.
And I get why they did it now. As a kid, I was like, okay. And you just like do it.
Right.
And now as an adult, I'm like, oh yeah, because people just eat shit.
Yeah,
and it's so fun to watch kids wipe out.
Just smashing the only your thighs reason. Together. Mm-hmm.
You just watch people run as fast, and you know that they're running so fast and it's uncoordinated that they're going to fall down and hurt themselves.
Right.
Three-legged race.
That's fine. It, Zach. Yes.
I thought I was going to go with like peg leg or something.
There was that one, and there was the potato sack race.
Potato sack.
Oh, man. My God. I saw Monroe.
Smash.
And I have it on video somewhere. I watched that video so many times. She was like in the lead. She was cooking. Uh-huh. She was doing great. And then just colossal face plant.
She was being the potato the whole time. Right, she's like, I am the potato. And then bam, smashed it.
Oh, man.
I've been there. I've plenty of sacks. Sack races have ended with me smashing my face across the finish line.
I love how seriously the people racing over in China, they were taking that.
I know.
They were determined.
Yeah. I mean, part of me wants to try it. Part of me is like, I will rip my hips out.
Yeah.
So.
It's an upcoming Olympic sport, I think.
Oh, that's what it's going to be. That's for sure. No, there's no way.
I made that up.
Oh, no, okay.
Oh, Zach, fuck you.
Zach.
All right, we've got one more To You from Internet clip for you. And this one, Zach, you can just bring this up right now.
Okay.
Because I'll explain as we go. This is just that I hinted towards it, that it was just like a weird thing that I found.
Yes.
At the front part of the show.
Yes.
This is a website called Window Swap.
Okay.
Where all you do is click buttons, and it just shows you the view from different people's windows around the world.
Oh.
That is it.
I was thinking something else for a second there. I was
not even
nervous.
Not even Creepy Tom. So this is, don't know.
Where is that? You just don't even know.
The window in somewhere. I think it tells you.
Oh my God. How many people have wasted 4, 5, 6 hours in a row on this just website?
I know. It's kind of neat.
I'm kind of
excited. So
what?
Now we're in Egypt looking at the pyramids out some random window.
That is ridiculous.
Isn't that fun?
Yeah, that's awesome.
Where we go next? You want to see?
Yeah, let's see next.
Oh, man.
These are pretty exciting windows so far.
Where'd my click button go?
Oh, no. Maybe you could max out. You gotta do premium.
No way. Yeah, premium. Peeping Tom package.
Mm-hmm.
You get to look the other way.
Oh, wow. This is like real time.
Yes.
Somebody's
actual
sweeping.
Live webcam
some
shots.
Part of the world. Somebody's sweeping out. Can you imagine?
And you could submit your window. Like right now, we're watching a little work van go by.
My brain is so fucked up.
She's got hit or murdered.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
That's immediately, I just imagine like, oh, you're clicking through, and then you click one and you just see a fucking murder happen. And then you're calling the police. You're like, I saw murder. And they're like, where's, I don't know.
Right out the
window. Swap.
Right out the window.
I saw it on window swap. What window? I accidentally closed my browser.
I have no idea.
But there was a redheaded lady.
A truck went by.
The guy, white guy, maybe 40-ish. Please find him.
Please
find him. He's going to kill again.
Sir, don't hang up. I can't help you anymore.
I don't know. All I know is, Windowswap.com! And then you just hang up.
I went to another window. I don't know where it is. I'm looking at the pyramids now. And nothing's happening here. But I just watched you get killed.
I clicked on what I thought was the address button, and I accidentally swapped it to another window.
Right, exactly.
Now I'm watching a nice lady garden in France.
Exactly. So that's it. And again, we'll put the link down in the episode description for window swap and that board thing and all that stuff.
That's one of those weird things where I would never in a million years think to invent something like that.
The window thing?
Yeah, the window thing. And I would think, and if somebody told me, I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah.
But now that I see it, I'm like, that's pretty cool.
Right. Or like, I picture it not even on my screen really, but like full screen on my TV at home.
Okay.
It's just kind of in the background. There's always like, you know, it's like a different window, weird connection to a different part of the world.
Who do they find? I mean, you can't.
You set it up.
You got to set it up so you can be part of it.
Yeah, you just hook up a cam to a computer and say, yeah, take my feed.
I'm so dumb.
Yeah.
But this is going to share another dumb thing. For a second there, I was all tripped up because I was like, I thought they just could magically look out windows.
Like just in the note?
Yep. You don't even, like, you don't know.
Like
you're living there and you're like, hey, that's my fucking window. You're like obviously, just for a second, I'm like, how could they, legally, how do they get the tech to do this?
Wow, tech is crazy.
I didn't even think initially that you'd have to get permission and sign people up. I was just passing swapping through there, and then you just all of a sudden you're looking at your own window. Like, I didn't agree to this.
It's like your face.
Like, I don't even have a camera.
What are you doing here?
What kind of demon shit is this? Windowswap.com.
What a world.
What a world.
This is crazy. Intrusive, but fun. All right. Well, thanks again. That goes episode 5.
That was fun.
I know. Before we take off, though, I do have an update. It's a small world update, and this was sent my way this past week by actually my good buddy from college, Jake Smith, who writes.
Okay.
And I'll set it up if I need to in more detail, but I'm not sure if I will.
Okay.
He goes, dude, first, love the podcast.
Are you jerking my bobber?
You fishing my fly? What you doing? You jerking my lure? What are you doing? And he goes, second, small world with your latest episode. And I think he's going back to episode 3 with this. He goes, at work, I sit next to David Rush, the wet sponge to the face record holder
guy.
This isn't like an acquaintance. Jake Smith's like a really good friend.
Right,
and he sits
right
next to fucking David Rush. And he goes, and I'm a stand-in for some of his world records where he needs a partner for. Like the longest hot dog throw and catch.
Is this guy baiting our hook?
No, he's not.
Okay.
This guy lubing my hook?
Lubing my hook?
I'm going to use that in the bedroom. Here, you can go ahead and bring it up on screen, Zach, really quick. So this is him. This is the world record. Here's my buddy Jake.
That's Jake. And he's part of it.
He's throwing the fucking wiener.
Okay.
That's what he's doing.
Okay, the longest
longest
hot dog throw.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pretty crazy.
Pretty crazy. They did it.
All right, well, back to the article here. he wrote, for the hot dog record, there was actually a kind of funny part. So we were at a pretty nice hotel for a work thing down in San Diego, and he had me throwing hot dogs at him in the parking lot. Bits of hot dog and bun were everywhere, so a flock of seagulls were chilling. After about 20 minutes or so, I realized two super hot girls had come out of the hotel and were just staring. And I think that the most irredeemable moment of my life is I don't think they saw him. They just saw me in a circle of 20 fucking seagulls hucking wieners down the parking lot wearing a shirt and tie.
That's awesome. Look at that maniac.
God, he's just like, yeah, you want some of this shit?
throw this hot dog down your hallway.
I hope they didn't see who he's throwing to. I hope they just thought it was a lunatic standing amongst seagulls,
hucking wieners
as far as he could throw them.
Just out of frame. Just breaking some kind of mental record.
God.
Anyway, so that's crazy.
That's crazy.
That's some
crazy.
Small world stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I found that amazing. All right, so let's officially wrap it up.
You know when you cast your line out, you never know where it's going to end up.
Never know what's going to bite.
You never know where you're going to reel back in.
Sometimes you get it snagged.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you get a bass. Fish.
There you go.
Big.
Yeah, a real.
You're the professional.
Oh, yeah. Pike.
I guess I have like a normal license plate.
Small mouth, big mouth. What are you talking about?
Medium mouth.
Northern pike.
Medium mouth bass.
Rainbow trout booked out. Come on.
Yeah. Dogfish. Is that something? As always, thanks to Zach Cohen for creating some of the custom music beds for the show. Thanks to Logan and Kate at Spicy Club for continuing to pump out the best merch in the podcast game and for managing our social media accounts. Whatever. The Keith! It's from Scared
to
Death.
Oh, yeah, The Keith.
Another episode, but it's funny. Go check that out.
And be sure to check out the Amazon Prime special, Get Out of Here, Devil. And if you don't like it, just skip right on to there's Joe Coy has a really good one. Chad Daniels. There's a lot of other comics that have really
amazing
good specials.
And I completely understand.
Chris Porter has solid stuff.
No, I'm not mad. I understand. There's some incredible series out there.
Maria Bamford. There's a lot of other people you can watch.
Thanks to Zach Flannery for producing, directing. Be sure to follow us on Instagram, Facebook, at IsWeDumb. You can also find us online at isbedumb.com. Those threads available at badmagicmerch.com. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Bad Magic Productions. If you want to send something in for one of the segments, that's dumb at isbedumb.com. Anything else, general questions, dick size.
Yep.
If you really want to know,
info
at isbedumb.com. Just don't be pissed when you get depressed when you send back.
Fishing advice?
Yeah. Fishing. I thought you said more for me.
No.
Just get toss it in. Like, yeah, you got to find your own hole, if you know what I mean, son.
If you want a question for the fish guru, you send it all in.
It's a brand new show. As always, reviews are very important. Thanks to everybody for checking it out.
You.
I mean, we are pumped at what is happening right now. So thanks to all the dummies out there.
A lot of fun stuff going on at Bad Magic Productions.
A lot of amazing stuff. Hopefully you're less dumb right now than you were heading into the episode. Mm-hmm. And before we let you guys go, we will wrap things up with the wow, neat fact.
Wow, neat fact.
Dan?
Yep.
Ready?
I'm ready.
Did you know the founder of Match.com, Gary Kramen, lost his girlfriend to a man she met on Match.com?
Ain't that a bitch?
Yeah. I mean, to him, it's like, it worked. It's working. Bye.